An Auckland man who killed his ex-wife during a frenzied attack will spend at least 19 years in prison. 65-year-old Li Manchao murdered Yang Zhimin with a hunting knife in the West Auckland suburb of Massey last July. He stalked his victim as she walked to her bus stop before tackling and killing her in broad daylight. Today, Justice Jagose sentenced Mr. Li to life behind bars. He was also sentenced for breaching a protection order. Our Checkpoint reporter Nick Truebridge was in the Auckland High Court this morning and explains how Li planned his attack. Now, just a warning, aspects of the case are distressing.
Li basically collected sort of an arsenal, I suppose you could say, of hunting knives prior to the attack. He also told his flatmates that he was planning on dismembering or killing her. Then in 2018, of course, a year prior to when the attack happened in 2019, he actually told his mental health support person that if he couldn't get redress through the courts because there was a property dispute between the pair, that he would look to get redress simply by harming her. He specifically said by chopping off her hands and or cutting off her feet. The morning of her death on July 29 last year, he actually parked up near her house. He filmed her as she came out of her house. He then followed her as she headed to her bus stop on her way to work. He came up behind her. She screamed as he tackled her. He then dragged her off the footpath into sort of a grassy area away from the footpath and, as we know, stabbed her multiple times.
This is an absolutely horrendous case, and from the detail you've just given us, very orchestrated and planned. There were people who were caught up in this, witnesses.
Yeah, so Justice Jagose referred specifically to a group of construction workers. One of the construction workers in particular said he saw the attack and estimated that Ms. Yang was stabbed about 12 times within the space of a minute. Her body then went limp before, as he described it, Li strutted from the scene. There was another witness, a young boy on his way to school. He actually walked past both Li and Yang on his way to school while he was walking up the footpath. Once he got further down the road, he heard a scream and Justice Jago said he was so scared that he kept walking instead of turning around. A number of other witnesses said that they heard screams and they simply described them as screams of absolute terror.
So there is no question that this was a ferocious attack. What do we know about the injuries that Ms. Yang sustained?
Yeah, so there were 10 stab wounds to sort of the front of her body, including a wound that went straight through her heart. There were also stab wounds that connected with bones, like her ribs, obviously creating a lot of damage there. There were stab wounds to her left hand and her left armpit, which were consistent with her trying to defend herself. And Justice Jagose, in going over some of the aggravating features that led to this sentence, commented that Mr. Li, in his attack, targeted some of her vital organs.
And so what did you hear from the family today, the victim's family?
Yeah, so the impact on them has been pretty serious. Her mother, the victim's mother, for example, now suffers from fairly severe depression, which can get so bad that she is often admitted to hospital because of the symptoms of that, the depression she now suffers from. In terms of the impact on her son, he commented that watching the CCTV was like watching a film or a movie, but at the end of that film, it's his mother that winds up dead. So it's a serious and lasting impact, particularly on her relatives.
Checkpoint reporter Nick Truebridge there.